the same ones that I died with. Put it all out on the line with. If you're looking for me, you can find wit in the new car or the crown whip. My new broad does a fine chick in the weather squad. I'm down with. Ain't no way around it. What you say? Tell me what you say. Working hard, repping for my dogs. Do this every day. Taking off, looking out for all. Making sure we ball like the mob. All you do is call. Catch you if you fall, young Khalifa.
I never fear death or dying. I only fear never trying. Judge me now. One shot, everything rides on tonight. Even if I got three strikes, I'ma go for it. This moment, we own it.
I ride a guy to
be played with because it can get dangerous.
Hey there, wrestling fans. Welcome to this week's edition of Superstars of the Ring, the 200th episode of Superstars of the Ring. I am your host, Eric Snook.
Frankie Morris.
And we're glad to be on the heels of WrestleBash 25, just around the corner. August 27th at Fernandina Beach Middle School. Of course, we're going to have a huge main event, a three-way dance with CCW champion Daniel Anderson taking on the unstoppable Eric Moore and the outlaw Jamie McKinnon.
That is indeed happening at WrestleBash.
Thanks for the input, Frankie. That was eloquent. That was well stated.
Do you notice the jacket?
I do notice the jacket.
You know what it's here for?
No.
It's the 200th episode.
Thanks for dressing up.
Looks good, right? Looks good, right?
Real good.
I wish I could talk back to me.
It's my jacket. Perfect. Now, anyways, like I said, we're on the heels of WrestleBash. In fact, one of our contenders, one of our number one contenders for the CCW Heavyweight Championship is the unstoppable Eric Moore. We recently caught up with him for an interview, and we're going to take it away to this week's interview of the week with the unstoppable Eric Moore.
2016, the main event, a three-way dance. The youngest superstar in CCW versus the oldest superstar in CCW. That's Jamie McKinnon, if you couldn't tell by the balding on top. And then you have someone that looks older than Jamie McKinnon, but actually his age is in the middle because he lost all his hair. So, let me tell you something. Yeah, Jamie, the CCW fans are over it. They don't want to hear you speak about your horse named Copus. They don't want to hear you shooting pistols and guns in Texas. No one cares. What they want to hear about is unstoppable Eric Moore walking in to the middle school gym in Fernandina Beach and leaving the CCW champion. Daniel Anderson, no one cares about you playing poker and betting money on your daddy and what he can do for you in the company. What they care about is Eric Moore walking into the middle school in Fernandina Beach and walking out with that belt. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm sick and I'm tired of all of the drama between you and Jamie and calling me a boy. I'm over it. I'll see you at WrestleBash and we're going to see who the man is.
Welcome back, wrestling fans. There we heard from the unstoppable Eric Moore, who hopes to walk out of WrestleBash 25 as the new CCW champion. Now, another championship we know we're going to crown a new champion of is the Alternative Championship. And that's going to be happening at WrestleBash 25.
Who's in that match?
One of the competitors in that match will be Frankie here.
Hey, everybody. I'm in that match.
Yep, that match, this is the way it's going to work, basically. We're going to have three tag teams in that match. Six competitors.
Oh, I'm just showing them, like, what could potentially happen in the match.
Okay.
A little sneak peek.
So Frankie will be in there. He'll have a tag team partner, and there'll be two other tag teams in there. Now, the first two tag teams to be eliminated from the match, they'll be gone. The last two competitors remaining will square off with each other, and whoever wins that will be crowned the new CCW Alternative Champion.
This coat's not very good for, you
know. The coat's not even yours, so.
I'm just saying you're a little small, and you might need to bulk up.
You went into my closet. It's weird. Anyways, our match of the week this week is going to contain another number one.
Well, maybe you shouldn't leave your closet unlocked, okay? That's all I got to say about it.
This week's match of the week is going to feature another number one contender for the CCW Heavyweight Champion, and that is the Outlaw, Jamie McKinnon. He recently had another match with the rising superstar, the martial artist, Jay Lee, who actually requested a rematch with the Outlaw, which might have been questionable in the first place.
Yeah, very questionable.
Speaking of questionable, there were some questionable things happening before that match. Care to elaborate?
I don't know. No record
yet. A lot of buzz going on around the locker room that evening.
No, there was no buzz. There was zero buzzing going on.
I mean, I just couldn't believe what was happening, really. So anyways, let's take you away to this week's match of the week featuring the Outlaw, J.B. McKinnon, taking on Jay Lee and
Frankie B.
Sure.
Our next match has a 30-minute time.
Welcome to Superstars of the Ring. In the ring, there you see one of the most intimidating and scariest figures in the history of Continental Championship Wrestling. That is the Outlaw, J.B. McKinnon. Now he's getting set to have a match with Jay Lee. For some reason, J.B. McKinnon is calling out the Yuli mascot here, Buzz. I have no idea what this is about. I highly doubt the Outlaw wants a photo op. With Buzz to be there, that doesn't make any sense. Of course, the poor guy can barely see to get to the ring. What is J.B. McKinnon thinking right now? Oh, and McKinnon's attacking the beat. Wait, that's Frankie Morris. Delivers a devastating lariat to Frankie Morris. And McKinnon just stopping him out of the ring. Morris goes to the floor. What in the world was that all about? That's one of the craziest things I have ever seen here in CCW. And now we hear the music of Jay Lee, who is McKinnon's opponent for this match. Now McKinnon still yelling back and forth with audience members here. Morris, Frankie Morris is on the ground in front of our announcer's booth here, ringside. And now we await the arrival of Jay Lee, and there he is.
The well-known martial artist, ladies and gentlemen,
believe it or not, Jay Lee actually requested this match against the Outlaw. They actually had a match a few months ago. Jay Lee was injured, so he requested a rematch to prove that he could take on the Outlaw, Jamie McKinnon. And Jay Lee might have more brawn than brains. I doubt anybody in that locker room would be a willing participant in a match against Jamie McKinnon. But who knows? Maybe Jay Lee has something in store for the former CCW Heavyweight Champion. He put up a good fight against McKinnon a few months ago, but ultimately lost in that match. McKinnon, of course, jumped at the proposition. Anytime anybody requests a match against him, McKinnon's not going to back down. He's a bad, bad man. Jay Lee just might be crazy. And this match is officially underway. There we hear the bell. Jay Lee actually getting the upper hand to start off this match. And there we go, McKinnon throwing furniture. That's what he's known for when he gets mad or frustrated. I can guarantee he's both mad and frustrated right now as he walks around the outside of this ring. Now McKinnon back in the ring. Jay Lee has shown vast improvement over the last year here in CCW. He started off with a very limited arsenal. And he has actually grown to be a pretty competent professional wrestler. And the confidence in himself is growing. But right now he's catching elbows in the corner by the Outlaw, Jamie McKinnon. McKinnon's always in a bad mood. Of course, I don't think I've ever seen him in a good mood. But in particular, he's been in an even worse mood since being stripped of his heavyweight title after last year's WrestleBash. Of course, he's doing a street fight with legendary Chris Turner. A match that was supposed to decide their careers, but instead, Society of Sin interrupted that match, lit a fireball at Chris Turner's face, and broke the arm of the Outlaw, Jamie McKinnon, which is why he was stripped of his title. But right now, you see Jay Lee really delivering it. Just took him down with an arm drag takeover. And somehow, we see Outlaw, Jamie McKinnon on his back and Jay Lee with the upper hand. Now he's got him in an arm bar, and McKinnon gets over to the ropes to break the hold, and he's gonna go back to the outside of the ring. And he calls a timeout, which we, of course, know does not exist here in pro wrestling. And working his way back into the ring now. It appears as though Jay Lee has done his homework. This is the most prepared we have ever seen Jay Lee here at CCW. He's grown in leaps and bounds. But that's some of that veteran tactics by McKinnon. The old thumb to the eye trick. Now McKinnon whips him into the ropes. A back elbow there. Jay Lee, a little dazed, a little confused. McKinnon showing why he's a veteran. He exposes that kneecap and drives the knee hard right into the skull of Jay Lee. And now he's choking him. Jay Lee's got the rope, so McKinnon forced to break the hold. Of course, he gives him almost the entire five count before he breaks that, before being disqualified.
Watch the eyes. Don't scrape into the eyes.
As you hear the referee, Mark Falcone warning Jamie McKinnon. Now he delivers an elbow right to the top of the head of Jay Lee, who is pretty unsure of where he is right now. And another elbow right across the chest and sternum of the martial artist Jay Lee. And another elbow. As much as Jay Lee has improved over the last year, just does not compare to the 2+ decades of experience that the outlaw Jamie McKinnon has here in professional wrestling. McKinnon goes to work on him, delivering forearms, backs him into the corner, and just laying those elbows and forearms into Jay Lee as hard as he can. Now he goes for it. A shoulder tackle. Jay Lee gets out of the way, and McKinnon goes shoulder first into that steel turnbuckle. And then we see if we get the momentum shifting back into Jay Lee's side. He goes for a big chop. And another one. McKinnon is reeling. Let's see if he's got another one. And he does. One. Unfortunately for Jay Lee, that was only enough to get a one count out of McKinnon. Jay Lee going up to the second turnbuckle. And another massive chop. And this is where he's got to be careful to not be too predictable. He's going to try another one, it looks like. But he connects. McKinnon is down. And again, Jay Lee goes back up to that second turnbuckle. Maybe wasting time here. McKinnon blocks it. Kicks him in the midsection. Shoulder tackle. And I think Jay Lee went to the well just a little too many times there. McKinnon caught on to the pattern. It looks like McKinnon's getting ready to deliver his patented lariat clothesline. Whips him into the ropes. Here we go. And there it is. The lariat. And that's all she wrote. Jamie McKinnon wins this match against a very brave Jay Lee. A noble effort by Jay Lee, but unfortunately for him, the experience of the outlaw, one out. Yeah!
Welcome back, wrestling fans. What an exciting match that we saw between Jamie McKinnon and Jay Lee. A lot of questions coming out of that match. Primarily, what were you doing in a B outfit?
You know, you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes. So I was just doing what I had to do.
What did you have to do exactly?
You know, be in a B outfit. So why don't you just do the rest of the show, okay?
So WrestleBash 25 right around the corner. Another big match that we're going to have that day is going to be Chris Turner, the legendary Chris Turner, taking on Solo Jones, a member of Society of Sin. These guys have not settled their feud yet. They have become bitter, bitter enemies. And I think this is going to be the penultimate match between these two guys. It's going to be gigantic. They're going to be falls count anywhere, street fight all over the building, do what you got to do. Somebody's going to have to win that match, but unfortunately somebody's going to have to lose that match.
Yeah, some would say that somebody has to win this match and that some are going to have to lose this match. So
we'll
see.
That's
something I've heard people say about this match before.
Wonderful input. Thank you. Thank you. Now this week we're going to have an interview with the Outlaw Jamie McKinnon to give us more of his thoughts on his upcoming CCW heavyweight title match at WrestleBash 25. Nothing? Okay. Just don't know when to chime in at all, do you? Next week, we have a very, very special episode of Superstars of the Ring.
Well, you see, I would know, but you never put on my cards.
You don't have cards.
Look, I did have cards when we first started this, okay, Eric?
Okay. Next week, we're going to have a very special episode of Superstars of the Ring.
Whoa. This is the 200th episode.
Yeah.
I'm wearing a jacket.
Yeah.
Well, how come you weren't so excited for this one?
I'm very excited.
We announced the title match that has me in it. Can't do this anymore, Snook.
Fine. So next week we will have a very special episode of Superstars of the Ring.
I didn't mean it, I'm sorry.
It will be our lead-up show to WrestleBash 25, which of course is coming up August 27th at the Fernandina Beach Middle School. We hope to see you there. We hope to see you again next week here on Superstars of the Ring. But for now, I'm Eric Snook.
Frankie Morris.
We'll see you next week.
At the 24th WrestleBash, I walked down to that ring. We strapped a rope to one another, and I nearly beat Chris Turner from an inch of his life. And that was just to have fun. And that's because I was the champion then, and I was in a good mood. Well, let me tell you something, Daniel Anderson. I don't care if you take pictures with Ole, Arn, or Gene. You know why? Because Gene's been dead 20 years, and I don't care about it. I want my belt back. You take your family legs, Lee, and stick it up your rear end. I don't care. Eric Moore, do yourself a young career favor. Don't come down to that ring. Think about it. Call your mama, call your daddy, get your sister on the internet and ask them, is this really a good idea to face the only person in CCW who doesn't mind crippling people?
For those of you that want to know what we're all about.